in Friends and Neighbors? Or shall I say this afternoon?
Welcome back to The Political Process here on the channel. I'm your host, longtime listener. Be sure to drop a like, hit the subscribe button, and comment below. We are 41-year-old Dwayne Bunker in week one of 2039, and we are in our now fifth term as a representative from the state of Pennsylvania. Now, if you remember at the end of the last episode, at the federal level, we got Wilbur Lester wrapping up his second term as president, so he's going to be gone. Then in the House, Democrats have taken a stronghold, and they've also taken over the Senate by a margin of 52 to 48. So we're primed for a presidential run, and it would be a great time to do it if we can pull it off. Now, we've got to go all in. Let's go back to my guy here and look at, I want to see, where's my finance? Where is, maybe, well, here's what we have: $2 million in savings, and we have $12 million in campaign funds already set aside. We've got a really high approval rating in the state of Pennsylvania, and we've got some political clout. So we're going to try and throw our name into the hat for the presidency. Now, full disclosure, I messed around with this a little bit just to kind of try and get a feel for some of the stuff that goes on during a presidential campaign versus what we've seen so far. And I think I've got a grasp of it. So we're still kind of feeling it out a little bit, but there are some things that I kind of know because I've already made mistakes and learned from them. We are not going to run for Speaker of the House. We're going to go ahead and vote for Mateus, and he is going to win in a landslide. Wait, we don't want to do that. We just want to vote for him, and he wins party lines. He's going to get her done. So, boom, Speaker of the House. Cliff Hobbs is the House Minority Leader. Now, nomination process for party leader. I think I might put my name in the hat here just because, like, why not? If I win the presidency, like, everything else doesn't matter. But if I can get this title, that's pretty awesome. And this is the guy that I would be doing it against. And I've got him smoked when it comes to political clout. Which is crazy considering that this guy is 76. Like, what the heck have you been doing your whole life? In 13 terms, he's only racked up that much political influence. So we are going to say yes here, and I'll bet you we win. And now, yeah, we won, and he didn't even vote for himself. Okay. So I will vote for me, and I am now the House Majority Leader. So that's cool. So there's a difference between Speaker of the House and then the House, you know, your party leader, if you are the majority, I guess. But anyway, so we'll say yes. Continue. Now, nomination for caucus chair. I've already been selected, so I am not eligible. That's fine. So we are going to vote for, let's see here. She's going to win. We have the same policy agreement, so it doesn't really matter. Let's just vote for her. Congratulations, Emma. And then party leadership introduction. I hope we can accomplish great things this year. Committees. We will go ahead and stay on the Appropriations Committee as the chair. So that's that. And I think that's all we need to do in week one. Now, if we go in and look at challenges, this is not going to get done by week 16 of 2040. I'm going to go ahead and dismiss that. Same thing with drug use and universal health care. These are things that we might be able to, like, write some legislation to try and change, but I'm not doing that unless I'm president, and I don't even know if you can, like, suggest legislation. I don't really know what's going to change as far as the mechanics of my day-to-day role once we actually win the White House, assuming we do, which we're hoping, and I think we can. So let's go ahead now and advance. Now, Democrats are setting the budget. You can see here they're going to try to eliminate the Medicaid expansion program, which was established last year or whatever by the Republicans. So one Republican voted in support of this budget, which is cool. Good for you. And now I've already learned that you can't throw your name into the hat for the White House until like week 18, I think. It's a while before you can even put your name into the ring, which is weird. But that's just the way it is. Budget resolution report. So what has changed? 4.536. We're still doing whatever. Just support it. It got more support this time. Yay. We do want to keep an eye on this tab just to make sure that whenever the president job pops open, we immediately put our name into the ring. Oh, we got political points for those two things. Yay. Reduce Medicare tax. Probably not going to happen, but we'll leave it in there for right now. Because basically we have 2 years to get it done. Okay, so if I win the White House, then hypothetically I could push to get that done next year or whatever. Let's see. Or in 2041, although I don't know that. We'll figure it out. Alright, so Florida Bates, grants for low-income school districts. I imagine that this is Democrats making pushes to increase access to some benefits or whatever, so we're not going to want to create any amendments here. And that was this one right here, I think, that we just did. So they are now trying to lower it. We're going to oppose. Democrats win. Now let's go down to the gas tax one. Actually, let's go ahead and finish this. We are going to support this. It wins. Yay. Hooray. And that should get done. And now let's go do through the same exercises with the gas tax. No, we do not want to create an amendment. We are against their amendment. And then we are in favor of the legislation to put it back to $1 a gallon for the gas tax. That passed. Hooray. And next turn. More stuff here. More challenges. Check just... Okay. Party can't... So... Now there's less to decipher there to see if the president one pops up. So, anyway. Florida bait. So what do we vote... So they want to increase access to temporary assistance for needy families. We do not want to create any amendments here. Republicans do. We are going to oppose. And now that we can vote, we are going to support. And it passed again. See how much stuff goes back and forth like a seesaw just because of what party has more people in office. It is that critical in this system to have the majority. And therein lies a major issue with the two-party system. So, all right, grants for low-income school districts. We want to give them more access. We support the legislation. Message from the Speaker of the House. Oh, so that was it? That was the actual vote, but whatever. All right, so next turn. Nothing. Next turn. Nothing. Come on, where's the presidency? I think it's week 18 that it pops up, which will be there soon. And there it is. So it's a salary of $400,000. We obviously don't care about that. We are going to apply for this. We're going to just pick Dan Fang. I don't know that it really matters. Like, if I come in here and say, you know, customize, I still, like, it doesn't really matter what I do here. So it's just kind of silly that they even give you that option. Now, for our campaign platform, we are going to focus on the economy, and we are going to go income per capita, just like we've been doing so far. This one, we are going to continue to focus on reducing crime. And now here, we're going to mix it up and go healthcare, and we're going to increase access to healthcare. That's our objective. So those are our campaign platform ideas. Now, if you see here, name recognition is now 4%. That's because this is national stuff now. We're playing in the big leagues. So it's not just Pennsylvania that matters. So we have a lot of work to do. First thing we're going to do is go into our staff and train them up. Boom. Get that done. Now, if we look at finance, we got lots of money here. This is what we're going to spend on our staff per week. We now have like events and stuff that I can do on a national level. I'm not going to deal with them right now because these don't really matter that much. Next week, there will be national interviews that I can do, and those we'll want to start taking advantage of. But it's time to start throwing some serious money at marketing. And also, we need to set up field offices. So here's my strategy here. For all the states that I don't think are going to matter that much as far as how much of a presence that I have there, we are going to set up, let's say, we'll leave Illinois. So, like, all of the states that I don't think are really going to matter as far as being swing states or whatever, we're going to just set up, like, one field office. Michigan definitely is a focal state. And then New York, we obviously want to spend some time on. Arizona can be a swing state. Not worried about Carolina or North Dakota. Ohio for sure. Pennsylvania, we will, just because it's our home state. And we obviously want to have a lot of excitement there. Rhode Island, South Carolina. We'll do a little bit extra effort in Texas just because of how big of a state it is. And then I think that's probably it for the states that I'm kind of concerned with. So what we're going to do is we're going to go like this and say, oh, come on with this. You know what? Let's just go all and let's say, oh gosh, that's a ton of money. two field offices per state. That's not quite how I wonder if I can do this and then go back to the states that I don't care as much about and add more. So remember this number, 116. Do that. Those have been opened. Now, I don't understand. Select states where you want to adjust volunteer. Oh, okay. So let's go like this. And now we want to do door knocking, a significant amount, and phone bank, a significant amount. We'll do a little bit of fundraising, but it doesn't need to be much. I'm not super worried about yard signs either. Let's get these up to 10% if we can. So it'll be 10, 10, 40, and 40. Confirm changes. Boom. So that's the kind of activities that they are going to do in those states. And now we need to go like this. And we already have one open per state. So I think what this is going to do is open another field office. But we're about to find out. So like if I go Arizona, California, Florida, Georgia, let's do Illinois. Let's do New York. Michigan, Ohio, Pennsylvania. Let's just go with that and say open field offices. Boom. Now, can I now see on the finance front, field office staff, see this number is now 145, and I'm not sure that that's that much more. That might be right, but either way, we'll just let it go. It's fine. we're going to kind of watch our campaign funds as we go, and we might open more. Like, let's just to test this. 145, 291. Now, just to test something here, let's go like this and say open. And we're going to say, let's put another one in Florida. Open. Open. And now let's go back to finance. And that number changed. So that's, we did that right. So every state has one. And then we've got several states that have additional field offices, with Florida being a big one. Ohio is probably another one. So let's actually go in there. And I mean, it's really close to our home state, and that may help us. But we still want to make sure that we have a huge presence in those critical battleground states. Now here, we're also going to be pretty aggressive, and we're going to say, let's spend 175. Actually, you know what? Let's spend 200,000 a week in campaign ads. It's a lot, but we're also going to be bringing in more. We're going to do this all over the country. I don't want any state to feel like I don't care. You know what I mean? We're going to just go general crime focus for our radio ads. For marketing on the internet, just a general ad. Of course, it's all states because it's the internet. How do you not do the internet in Kentucky? Whatever. Anyway, direct mail, we're going to go general economy, economic growth, boom, and target everyone in all states. Skadoosh. Now, I could do attack at, actually, endorsement. What? Funds provided this marketing will be, no, we don't care about that. So there, we've got 200 grand being spread across those four types of campaigns every week. Now, if we look at our opponents here, there are a bunch. We don't necessarily know who is going to be the front runner out of the gates, but we'll find out real quick whenever we do a poll. Like if we go here and go pick a state and say Florida, conduct a poll and check for voter intention. As you can see, we are way, way down. Wyatt Payne is way, way up. And then there are a couple of others that are, you know, getting a decent share of the votes as well. The reality is, I imagine, like, I don't know who Wyatt Payne is, but he might be from Florida, and maybe that's why he's getting that much of a bump there, or he could be from Georgia where he's close. But bottom line is, these numbers are going to change whenever we start throwing tons and tons of money at this. So I'm not super worried about it yet. But that's not a good sign. So let's go ahead to the next turn. We don't care about election night coverage. Now, our name recognition is up a little bit, but not much. You can see here, we did 34 hours of fundraising and brought in 200 grand. We're spending all of that money on marketing, but we can spend more. Now, you remember, like if I go into finance, okay? So we are spending, as you can see here, we spent 260 grand. We brought in 206. Is that right? Oh, so 260 plus the 180 that we spent on marketing? No. What in blazes? Why is this not as high? Either way, we're bringing in about half of what we're spending or what we plan to spend, so we can increase our marketing efforts pretty significantly. Let's make it 300,000 and leave everything else the same. Now, when we go to events, look at this. I can be on the National Morning Show. This is going to get me a lot of exposure. Boom. So that's a lot of name recognition that we went up. Now, as you can see, Republicans are now down to 49%. That's because this is at a national level. This isn't just Pennsylvania. So, of course, I'm not going to get as high of support in Tennessee. That's a, you know, super red state, as I would in Pennsylvania. So, I expected those numbers to go down. They did. This number still being that high is a good sign. But we're going to keep doing some of these to continue to try and just increase name recognition as much as possible. Now, there are going to be other events that pop up, like, where would that be? Like rallies and fundraising and stuff that I can do. We're not worried about those yet. And we probably won't be until... Oh, here, campaign map. So, like, let's just... This is interesting here, because, like, I can click on Pennsylvania. And now I can say... What does this predict election? What? So... Okay, so if I go to Pennsylvania now... Where are you, Pennsylvania? So... It's still not quite known. So this is basically just saying whether a Republican or Democrat is going to win. Still a lot up for grabs, as you can see. But some of the states are pretty much already decided. Like, everybody knows Alabama, Arkansas, Idaho. Like, there are a bunch of states that are just going to go that way. But I thought that I could click on this and see... Okay, here. See, like, name recognition in Florida is 2%. Whereas in Pennsylvania, it's 100%. So, here's what we're going to do. We are going to travel to Florida. Okay? Just one time, just to kind of show you how this works. And now if I go to Florida, where is it? I can go to some rallies and spend time and effort just doing those kinds of things to try and boost name recognition. Like, I'm not going to do a lot of that until... after the primaries, though, because, like, you see here, ooh, increase in voter turnout, 953, you know, voters. And the reality is, like, I had to spend time and money to get there. It's just not worth it. So we're going to just continue doing national interviews or whatever. Like, here I can go, where shouldn't there be, where is it? Whatever, not a big deal. Let's just go to the next turn. Now, I should be back in my home turf. Where are... Oh, interviews. I should have looked to do interviews... See here, like, I'm still in Florida. Okay? So, while I'm in Florida, I can do this interview show. Boom. This one. Boom. And then, let's pick Osceola County and do an interview there. Trying to get some recognition... in Florida while I'm here. So that's kind of the objective for being here. But now, let's go ahead and let's go ahead and skip to the next week. We need to kind of watch our campaign funds, but for right now I think we're doing okay. See, we're up to 10% at a national level. We need that number to continue to skyrocket, okay? So we're going to keep focusing on doing interviews. And now what I think I want to do is actually go to the campaign map and let's go to, like, Texas. Texas is one where you could win Texas if you spend enough time there. So why not travel there? You see here, it's going to take 5 hours. Actually, you know what? Let's go to Georgia since we're already right there. So let's go to Georgia. It's not going to take long. Why does it take 3 hours to get from Florida to Georgia? That's up, like, what's up with that? Whatever. Maybe we're in South Florida. So let's go ahead and travel there. Yes. And now, how much time do we have left? Oh, so we still have lots of time. We can do, like, a local interview here in... Bibb County. You kidding me with this, guys? Whatever. So, if I go to office, see, like, I need to start doing some of these things. So, this is going to be a busy episode. Next turn, I don't care about these appropriations. We are going to oppose that. I'm not going to look at that stuff too closely because my focus is right here. On this campaign, we got to win the presidency. Okay, Now, if we look at an overview, we're now up to 12%. Let's do another event here. We did Bibb County. Let's do Douglas County. And now, what else? Anything I need to do here? No. So let's go like this. That all looks good. Continue. Oppose. Come on, guys. Why are we supporting such a reduction in spending on the military? I don't get it. All right. And it's like every year they do that. Okay, so we've got 50 hours again. We're going to do another national interview. We're going to do a primetime interview. And we are going to now travel to... We're in Georgia, aren't we? Yeah. Let's go ahead and go to Texas. And let's travel to state. 4.5 hours, 20 grand. That's fine. See, we have 9% name recognition in Texas. Like, being in the state didn't really do that much, frankly, which is kind of disappointing, but it's okay. Now, let's see. So we're in Texas here. I could do some, like, rallies, but they're not very fruitful from what I've seen. We've already done some interviews. I want to actually go and do a poll now, and let's do Florida again. So actually, hang on. So here's where we were. We were at 2%, and then, you know, 54, 23, 20. So it's a four-horse race there, but if we do another one, I'll bet you we've closed that gap. We have taken the freaking lead in Florida. That's what I'm talking about. Not just closing the gap, eliminating it, reversing the gap. Let's check Georgia. We're winning in Georgia. So things are looking good now. So let's just keep doing what we're doing, and we will eventually, hopefully, make this. Let's bring it home, baby. All right, so let's do some written interviews as well on a national level. We've got some time. We're now in Texas. We're going to spend a few days here. We're going to do a Brazos County evening news interview and some more primetime interviews. Anything I need to do here? Energy bill. That looks good. Continue. Sure. They want to reduce spending. I'm going to oppose that. And now, go ahead to the next turn. Finance looks good. Nope, not legislation. Let's go to the campaign here. Do some more interviews. Smith County. So that's now a couple of days in Texas. Next turn. And now let's go ahead and travel to, which one's Arizona? This one, right? Oh man, that was kind of sad. It took me a second. I'm like, no, that's Nevada, that's Utah, Colorado. I mixed New Mexico and Arizona threw me off for a second there. So okay, now we're in Arizona. So let's go ahead and travel to Arizona. And you can see here, we're already now at 15% name recognition. So that's increasing across the country because of our efforts. But like in Texas, it's still 15. Still, like, going to the state hasn't made a huge difference, but it might make just enough difference in the general election to where I'm cool with this investment in time right now, because it's really just a little bit of time and money, not huge in the grand scheme of things. To where I fear that it will jeopardize the primary. All right, so back to the campaign front. Let's do interviews. Interview number 3. And then this has to be like where Phoenix is. Well, maybe not. I don't know. All right, here we go. This is big time viewers on the local front. Morning show, cable news, primetime news. Get it, son. 21% name recognition across the country. Interior budget, check. next. Education, health, and labor. All those. See, this one is down. It did that last time. I started to mess with it. What if I just say balance? If I do that, like, it's not doing anything to account for that. It's fine. All right. So that's what we needed to do for our normal duties. Now, campaign. So let's do the National Morning Show primetime news program for the most viewers. Let's just do all of those, and now we're going to travel again. Let's just go ahead and jump to California just to say we were there. Boom. You got to remember, during the primary, we need to win against other Democrats. So we have to go to the states that aren't necessarily just battleground states. So there's a little bit of that going on here. All right, overview. Where are we at? We've got 35 hours left. We just traveled to California, right? Yeah. So let's go ahead. Let's do one evening interview and then jump ahead. We'll do another evening interview. Morning shows. We're getting a lot of exposure here with all of these interviews. We're up now up to 25% name recognition. They are running some attack ads. Wait. They're attacking each other, which is awesome. Don't attack me. Attack each other. Let's go and run a poll. Is it... Can I do a national poll? Primary voter intention. So you can't do a primary. Let's go back to Florida. Do another voter intention readout here. We're still in the lead. Now, the Republican race is not even close. Let's also go to California. That's not necessarily a battleground state. And see, here it's tight. It's real tight. So, we need to stay aggressive, but we're doing okay. All right, so I think we're ready to go ahead and let's actually do this. Boom. Amend, increase spending. It's the same exact number. Whatever. That was the most U.S. government thing I've ever seen. All right. So, provides. What? Sure. Whatever. It doesn't matter. Oh, that was an amendment to that. It's okay. It's not a big deal. At least I hope it's not a big deal. Somebody might be on the evening news tonight. Like, did you see what he did? And be like, no. I just checked the wrong box. It's okay. I'm really tired from campaign. No. How do you talk your way out of that? All right, so let's do another local interview here, and then next week we're going to move on. So the State Department, check. Now, on the campaign front, let's travel to Illinois. It's a long flight, but it's okay. Now we go here. Boom. Boom, boom, and next, good there, boom, 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 and then Winnebago County, doing a little TV interview there, talking to the local news heroes. All right, 30% recognition. Let's run a poll in Illinois since we're there. It's really tight there. It's me and Wyatt from the looks of things. But they're still attacking each other, which helps me. So I wonder how I'm doing in Pennsylvania. I'd like to look at that, actually. We'll do that in a second. We are going to oppose that. What? All right, now let's go back to the campaign. Run a poll. Let's go to PA. Conduct. Boom, boom. How we doing? Yeah. So we're crushing in our home state. That's good. And we're really tight in a lot of the other states. So there's a, like, we have a chance to get that primary nod. And that's what we're looking for here. Get the primary, and then it's head to head, me versus the Republicans. And look at this. Our campaign funds are actually holding steady. So you know what that means? We're going to spend another $50,000 a week. In fact, we're going to spend another $100,000 a week. Because why not? All right. Now, we've got all of our time left this week. Let's go to Madison County. Let's do the morning show and the primetime interviews. And let's move ahead. All right. It's probably time to move on from Illinois. So let's go here. Nothing on the office tab to take care of as far as the budget goes. So that's good. We're finally past some of that stuff. 33% name recognition. So let's go morning show, prime time. And now we're going to move to Michigan. Very important state. We only have 31% name recognition here. So like, why are we so high? It's probably just because Pennsylvania skews it. But anyway, we are going to travel to Michigan. It's not going to take long. It's not going to cost much. So now that we're there, let's go ahead and jump forward. And let's start knocking out some interviews. Right? Ottawa County, boom. What county is Detroit in? I feel like I should know the answer to that. All right, so it looks like all the budget stuff is done. And we are coming up on the presidential primary here, y'all. So this is going to be big time. Or some debates or something. There's something coming up. So campaign funds are now finally starting to bleed down, but that's okay. Like, I'm not super worried about that yet. Let's go events. We're going to do just the morning show and some primetime stuff. Let's just do another one here. And now week 38. Nothing to do there. Let's look at challenges. Road quality, I'm sorry, but that's not going to get done. And then I'm actually going to delete all of these other challenges just so fresh ones pop up. Okay, so now office, let's go campaign, 40%. We're bringing in a lot of fundraising here. That's what I'm talking about. Next, look at that, 500K. Although, did I skip events that week? It's okay. I didn't do interviews, but it's not a big deal. Let's do those, and now go to the campaign map and travel to Ohio. Short trip. Come here, do a Butler County interview. Events. Make sure there's nothing on there that I need to do. Mahoning County. And then national interviews. Next, Lorain County. And now let's travel to New York. Okay. So now what? The first primary election will take place next year. I guess that's week 18 of next year. I was thinking that that would be this year, but I don't know why. It's okay. All right, so we're still raising a ton of money, and we're raising more and more now. 25 hours, we raised 400K. So, like, look at our campaign funds start to shoot up. And I wonder if people are, like, just dropping out of the race, or if it's, like, our name recognition is getting high enough to where we're starting to rake in more money. Like, we're at 46. I feel like that jumped a lot just in the last week. All right, so Monroe County will do. Let's do these. And then look at finance. Yeah, like, we're bringing in some serious cash here, y'all. Loving it. Let's go here. Go like this. We're going to open field offices in every single state. One more getting opened. And now when we go here, we're going to spend a little bit more, but that's okay because we're raking it in, baby. All right. Nothing to do there. Participate in the primary debate. Oh, man, I don't know if I would have missed that if I would have hit next turn. But let's go here. Continue. What message do you want to communicate about your economic policy? Each option will have a different effect on how the audience responds. Explain how it's consistent with the ideology and values of your party. Explain how they are the best policies for the country. Explain my intention to work with both parties and draft economic legislation that both parties can support. I'm leaning towards one of those two. We're not going to do this. And then, yeah, so I think we're going to just go right here and say, this is why we think, actually, you know what? I think this one is probably, it might hurt my chances in the general or in the primary, but it drastically increases my chances in the general election if I can continue to stay on that moderate ground. So let's go with that. See, we lost some Democrat voter enthusiasm, but we gained significantly in terms of independence. It didn't affect Republicans because they're probably not watching the Democratic primary. Boom. All right. So government spending helps the economy. We should do something, blah, blah, blah. Individuals who want. So I'm kind of worried about this guy just because he seems to be my biggest opponent. My own opinion is that the government has a responsibility to do what is best for the average citizen, and the living wage is what's best for the average citizen. The rich used to pay a much higher tax rate. I believe we should return. So this is basically him going down the Democratic side of things. This one was an attack on somebody. Wyatt actually was one of my other big contenders, wasn't he? So he went kind of down the road of income inequality is a serious issue, and yet fools in the opposition party and even in our own party refuse to address the issue. It's time we do something about it. Whoa. I'm not worried about Bruce or any of these other ones. Have not really been that big of a threat from what I've seen. I didn't actually watch to see if anybody was attacking me, but so far I have not seen anybody try to do it in any of the ads, and that's awesome. All right, so let's go ahead and move forward now. Nothing here to do. We're at 50% name recognition. We raised $331,000 in just 25 hours, which is awesome. Campaign funds continue to go up instead of down, which is awesome. Nothing to do here. Keep it going. Oh, man. I didn't spend any time doing interviews. And I think I'm still in New York, aren't I? Yeah. So we just kind of took a break that week from the spotlight. Which is fair, considering I'm coming off of the... Let's go back home. Let's go home, okay? I don't think it really matters where we are at the moment, so it's not a big deal. Now, if we hit predict election, nothing has changed here. So, nobody on either side has done so well in any of those swing states to determine which way it's likely that they're going to go. So that's neither good nor bad for us at the moment. What do we need to do here? We've already done our stuff. Election night coverage. Sure, we'll watch. These are the local elections, and gubernatorial races in a few states, but why am I... Yeah, whatever. Doesn't matter. All right. Campaign funds actually went down a little bit, but that's okay. Name recognition still going up. And now, like, we can't increase name recognition in Pennsylvania, so we might as well get out of here and go somewhere. So I'm not going to waste any time with local interviews. Let's get back out on the road. It doesn't cost me time or money to be on the road. It just costs me time and money to get on the road, if that makes sense. Like, it's one time you travel to Florida, and then you're good. While you're there, it doesn't cost you anything else, which is kind of silly, but whatever. All right, so nothing to do there. Let's go back to the campaign front, and we're going to travel back down to, let's go to Georgia, I guess, first. Spend some more time down here. Do the Henry County Evening News next. Cherokee County, sure. And now, skip, attend the Thanksgiving Day Parade in Atlanta, apparently. Awesome. And now, back to the campaign front. Richmond County, this will be our last day in Georgia. Then we'll move along again. Let's go like that, like this. Go like this next. Yes. All right. We could probably do the Brevard County interview there. We'll do Manatee County. Protect the manatees, or save the manatees, I think is the slogan in Florida. Because they are, I don't know that they're endangered. Look at how much money we're raking in, y'all. We're way up on campaign funds. We're now at 60% name recognition. This is good. Florida turnout is going up, and that's good. So, anyway, things are going well here. Let's go to Brevard County. No, we already did our interviews for this week, right? Yep. New challenge. Universal health care, tightened border security, whatever. Not a big deal. Volusia County. I've never heard of that county. I've spent some time in Florida, but I don't know that one. Next. Now we're going to travel. Let's go to Louisiana. It's pretty red. But actually, you know what? Let's find one that's kind of... How about Iowa? Let's go to Iowa. Why not? Do some interviews there. A lot of interviews. The Sunday, it was like a Sunday news something or other there. That was different. Nothing to do in the office. And now we have reached the end of the year. Now we're already running for president, so we don't need to do anything on that front as far as like announcing our candidacy, but campaign funds continue to shoot up. This is good, because now what I'm going to do, you ready for this? Boom, boom, boom. Do it. We're going to open additional campaign offices. Every time we start to see our campaign funds going upward, we're going to open new offices and we're going to increase our marketing efforts. I'm not doing this to sit here and have a huge campaign war chest. I want to win. And we're going to do whatever we have to make that happen. All right, so now look at this. National Morning Show, prime time, and the Sunday news program is a big one, and I'm wondering if that's because I've gotten to where I'm so popular that it's now like they're willing to have me on. So let's actually go and run some more polls here, and that'll be the last thing. Actually, Yeah, let's go ahead and advance to the next week. Now, oh man, there's a lot going on here because now it's like the year of the election, I guess. And you can see here, upcoming elections, it shows week 6 in Iowa. So I imagine that that means that like in week 5, we want to be in Iowa and do a bunch of interviews there to try and get as much recognition locally as we can. That's a strategy that we will kick into gear in the next episode. But for right now, we've already kind of gone around and locally in some of the states, at least, tried to raise some voter recognition, which could help us. But what I want to do to end this episode is conduct another poll, and we're going to do them in several different states. Basically all the swing states that we've kind of talked about. So Arizona, and it's tight, but we're losing to Bruce Lomax. Then we will go to Florida. It's tight, but we're barely beating Wyatt Payne, and Bruce is nowhere close. Bruce is on the loose. Georgia. We are pretty significantly out in front in Georgia. Let's check Illinois, because I know we spent some time there. We are losing big time. 16.6%. Wyatt Payne has a pretty comfortable lead, and we're behind. We're third there, which is interesting. Let's check Iowa. Iowa, we are losing. Bad. It's okay, though. We'll go there and try and increase our presence a little bit. Michigan. Michigan, we've got a stronghold. That's good. I'm not worried about Pennsylvania. Let's go ahead and look at, let's look, you know, not New Jersey. Let's just go ahead and just check New York. New York, we are losing pretty significantly. And then Ohio. What do you got for me, Ohio? We're way out in front in Ohio. So it's kind of all over the place right now. But we're doing okay. Most of the states we are, I would say the majority of the states that we looked at, we were leading. Some of them were really close. Some of them we were barely losing. And then there were a few that we weren't even, you know, really that close. But that's okay. It's just the primary. We just have to win the overall primary. And I'll bet you if we looked at states, let's actually look at like Tennessee. And you see here, this is what I like. When I go to Tennessee, we're getting 38%. No one else is really that close. That's a state that we haven't even focused on. And the reason why we're getting that support is because we're not like bleeding heart liberal Democrat. Like this is a good sign that on a national level, we could win a lot of the red states where we don't even have to spend a lot of time during the primary going to campaign. We will during the general election, just because you kind of have to. But the general good sign here is that we looked at one red state and it's a clear, you know, victory for me, which could propel us to at least getting the Democratic nomination. And then it's like a 50-50 chance that we win. So that is going to do it for this episode. I think we got a lot done. I'm excited because I think we can actually win this thing. And I'm liking that the other opponents don't even seem to be that worried about me yet, which is interesting because like I feel like we are the favorite and they're all attacking each other, which is like a perfect storm. So anyway, that'll do it for this episode. If you have not done so already, please be sure to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, comment below, and we will see y'all next time.
Good evening, friends and neighbors. Or shall I say this afternoon?